Next thing we're gonna do is place this one. This is the proxy blocker for the top. Also, what we're gonna do is put a blob of hot glue at those ends here. So we have this fixed. That's kinda important. So our epoxy doesn't run away. Now we get the support blocker in place, like this. And we're gonna glue it down with some tape, like this. And then just mounting it here. So this is our blocker. It blocks the epoxy from getting onto the LED itself. Looks good, looks good. Now we need a fitting. So we have our two fittings. And we're gonna give them a little bit of a epoxy dab. Giving it a little bit of a dab right here. Making the fitting tight. And now we can screw the fitting in. Hoppala, this was a fail. But second try. That looks better. So that is the one side. Now we can screw it down and hope for the best. So this should be tight without any problems. Let us now do the other side. Give the fitting a little dab. Getting the epoxy all on there, so we get a nice and tight seal. Now we screw it in again. And we take the, for getting it all in there. This should be tight. That's enough. So, and now the last step. We're gonna pour the main part. Now we start over here. Very, very slowly. We don't wanna overfill it actually. I mean, a little bit of overfill isn't the problem. Yeah. Looks good to me. Looks good to me. So, that's basically it. And we still have some epoxy left. So, we're gonna do a little bit on another LED. I'm gonna put this away to cure. Yeah, and that's basically it for today. I'm gonna clean up all of this and see you again.